Climate smart agriculture has to be about the whole agri-food system. We see climate smart agriculture as fully consistent and aligned with food security goals.
We see actually quite a range of activities going from the field scale all the way up to the landscape scale help develop an overall strategy and much broader scope for climate smart agriculture.
The opportunities that await us are really fully consistent with economic profitability drivers.
These issues are seldom separate or operate in isolation. So you don't just have a weather event unconnected to an economic event.
Although we tend to focus on production and at the farm level, the agriculture is much broader than just production, and we need to consider how we're addressing climate across our value chains, which would be in things such as trade and processing.
The way that farmers may engage in agricultural practices on their small plots is obviously situated in a social context and an ecological context.
I think we need to be thinking about social differentiation when we roll out interventions related to water and related to climate smart agriculture more generally, because we need to make sure that these interventions are reaching the most vulnerable members of the community. These may be women, these may be the poorest. So we need to think about the intersection of all these different characteristics, such as gender, age, marital status, and ethnicity, class. There's so many issues that we need to consider when we're rolling out these interventions so that we really make sure that the people who need the greatest help are getting it.
Gender underscores everything that we do. In many ways, women farmers are particularly vulnerable because they are saddled with greater responsibilities in the household, not only growing food that families will eat, but they also have the responsibility of gathering water, sometimes walking long distances to collect water. Women have the responsibility of collecting firewood, again, walking long distances to collect cooking fuel. And because of this, they're often unable to participate in agricultural extension activities like training on some of these improved technologies. So as researchers and development practitioners, we're looking for ways that we can reach women farmers in different ways rather than the conventional approaches, which are probably better suited for men farmers.
We have to figure out ways to capitalize African agriculture. And I think what we're going to see is that climate smart agriculture is wholly consistent, not just with environmental drivers, but also with economic drivers. Many of those kinds of value chains and economic opportunities have very significant gender opportunities associated with them.
So it's kind of win-win-win, that triple win that we like to talk about in climate smart agriculture.
We often have closely held assumptions about the linkages between what goes on in the farm and the impacts on the larger landscape. And those assumptions are often poorly examined. Using an approach called participatory system dynamics modeling, we're able to test those assumptions to see if they in fact make sense, are valid, and if they are not, then it allows us to shift our priorities to where they can have the greatest development outcomes.
Well, I would like to think that one of the new tools that is getting to farmers more and more is just the perception. It's odd to say that it's a tool, but this perception by the international development community that the social issues, the social networks, the community issues are probably the greatest tools that communities have to deal with these things.
System dynamics models have been employed from everything from public health and the way that diseases spread to the way that agriculture interacts with its own environment.
But at the same time, they can really use more information and figuring out how to work that within their system, building it on the information that they already have and the things that they already know.
But the point here is that we can always do better.
Now, I am hopeful that in the future we can build agricultural systems that spare more land and share more with the rest of the planet. But we're going to have to focus on that. That requires really focusing on things way beyond just yields of a few basic staple crops per land area.